Spray patterns are probably not the first thing that comes to mind when making an FPS multiplayer game. In my opinion, spray patterns are what separate the men from the boys. Are you going to spray your foes down, or be praying in the corner wanting to go back to Halo? Just kidding, I love Halo. If you're crazy like me, or perhaps you're working on an FPS game and you noticed how unrealistic it is to have a laser weapon, tackling spray patterns was one of the first things I did after getting the basics up and running. When I was designing my FPS controller, the first gun I added after the pistol was an M16 or AR of some kind. Don't hate on me, I'm Australian, I know nothing about guns. It was a rifle, an automatic one. It was the first time working with an automatic style weapon, and it became painfully obvious early on that without any recoil or spray patterns, a hitscan weapon just isn't fun. You see, hitscan weapons have no lead time. The minute you pull the trigger, a hit is registered wherever it landed, which is fine for a video game, but with no spray or recoil, it makes it a lot harder for the person being shot at to avoid anything. There's also an added skill cap to the game with the recoil. A player has to learn how to control the weapon, that is, if the pattern remains consistent. The very first thing I tried in my game was generating a random number between 0 and 1 and adding it to the X and Y axis of my raycast, which is, of course, the thing that actually controls where the weapon is firing. This got the job done visually, but being random meant that it gave the player little to learn about controlling it. In my opinion, a spray pattern that travels in a straight line isn't as interesting or challenging to control, and if the pattern is too random, then it's frustrating if you miss your shots, since you have less control. Recoil is only fun if the player can master it. But how do you get consistent spray patterns? Well, I experimented with using patterns generated with code, and it worked. It was consistent, but I was using the weapon stats to calculate the pattern, and it meant that if I didn't like the pattern, I had to change things like ammo capacity and fire rate. Then on top of that, they didn't vary that much. I don't know, maybe I'm just bad at math. So I gave up on that idea and decided to do it the hard way, with a big fat list of vectors. And this works okay, but it kind of sucked having to map everything out. Then I thought, I need to combine the two. I can keep the vector list, but I'll use a classic formula from high school to control the increase in distance between the shots. That formula that I'm talking about is the Pythagorean theorem. Now, do we really have to open up old wounds like that? Unfortunately, yes. Also, don't worry, we all had our fair share of cringe, especially me, so let's focus on the math rather than all of that unresolved trauma from your teenage years. Or is it just me? So I'm sure we all remember that spiral thingy from high school. For some reason that popped into my head when working on all of this. It's called the Spiral of Theodorus. I can use the hypotenuse to calculate an increase in the amplitude of this spray. Each shot will store the hypotenuse in a variable, and on the next shot, use the result to recalculate another hypotenuse. This increases the variable every shot, which is multiplied by the vector map and emitted out as a signal for the player controller and the raycast. We can use the A side of the triangle to control the amount that the hypotenuse will increase each time. The incremental increase from that spiral is just what I needed to control the spread of my spray. This way, my vector list can be something like 0 and 1 for up, and negative 1 and 1 for diagonal right. It meant I didn't have to worry about manually inputting the increase in spread over time. It would just happen naturally and look good. It made tweaking the spray amount easy because all I had to do was increase the A side of the triangle, and naturally the spray would spread further. To demonstrate this effect, I've made a new gun called the Theodorus. It has a spray vector that simply draws a circle. I've also turned off the camera shake and weapon kick, as what we're about to do produces some sickening motion, even for me. See how the gun's spray makes its way outward? This is the exact same thing that you see in those spirals. and my spray map is just ones and zeros. This lets me focus on defining the direction of the spray and not have to worry about the amplitude of the spray. I have added a modifier to increase the bass, which in turn increases the amplification of the spray. It was also helpful for when I wanted to add increase to spread or spray from movement. I simply add a modifier that will increase that side of the triangle temporarily when movement was occurring, which would push the player's gun further into the sky. Also, I discovered a cool trick for counting through an array indefinitely. So as an added bonus, I don't even have to match the number of vectors in the spray array. For example, the pistol only has 3, even though it has 13 rounds. It's got a very small spray effect, and it's not automatic, so it resets a lot more often than an automatic weapon, so it doesn't need a massive spray vector. This is really handy addition for less complicated weapons if you still want a little kick, but you can repeat it because it won't be visually obvious. Okay, so after all that math, we have a signal being sent out up the tree to the kinematic character. Right now, the character is responsible for handling the mouse input, so it interacts a lot with the guns, which are their own class. It receives the signal, and so does the raycast, which is actually doing the aiming. We add the spray calculation to the X and Y of the raycast every shot. With the Theodorus spiral, that number increases a little, and we're adding to every shot, so it pushes it further and further every shot. Then on the character, we're also rotating the camera on a smaller scale by this same spray vector, with a sprinkle of randomness thrown in. But not too much, just enough to have tiny little variations here and there. This gives a little more amplification to the spray, as rotating the camera also moves the aim raycast that calculates the hit. We store the location of the camera as the shooting begins, then when the shooting ends, we tween it back to the same spot, and we also reset the raycast back to zero on both the X and the Y. If you put all of this together, you get a fairly convincing spray pattern that can be easily tweaked to look like anything you want. Here is the AK-47 mimicking the spray pattern from CSGO. Here, the AR-15 is mimicking the spray pattern of the Vandal from Valorant. And then there's the pistol with just a tiny little bit of recoil. Okay, so that's how I'm doing recoil in my FPS game. What do you think? Does it need tweaking? Or do you think this is good enough to work with for now? Make sure you subscribe and hit that like button if you want to see more of what I'm doing with this multiplayer FPS game. As always, the source code for this project is available on my itch, if you want to go through and see how bad my coding really is. Or use it in your own projects. I'm not your dad. Anyway, thanks for watching. Or do you think this is good?